With the help of the earth gravitational force, you can explain the acceleration due to gravity. When we throw any object in upward direction, at this time, the velocity of that object goes on decreasing. That means there is change in the velocity. And it reaches a maximum distance and its velocity becomes zero. Again, this object falls down toward the center of the earth only due to the earth gravitational force. ज्यावेळेस एखादा ऑब्जेक्ट आपण वर फेकला गेला त्यावेळेस जसजसा तो वर जाईल तसतशी त्याची व्हेलॉसिटी कमी होत जाते, कारण ऍट द सेम टाइम अर्थ ग्रॅव्हिटेशनल फोर्स ऍक्ट्स ऑन इट इन डाऊनवर्ड डायरेक्शन. ड्यू टू दिस रिझन द व्हेलॉसिटी ऑफ दॅट ऑब्जेक्ट गोज ऑन डिक्रीजिंग वेन इट रिचेस अ मॅक्झिमम डिस्टन्स. दॅट मीन्स देर इज रेट ऑफ चेंज ऑफ व्हेलॉसिटी, बट वेन इट रिचेस अ मॅक्झिमम डिस्टन्स अँड इट्स व्हेलॉसिटी बिकम झिरो, ओनली अर्थ ग्रॅव्हिटेशनल फोर्स ऍक्ट्स ऑन इट. Due to this reason, it falls down toward the surface of the earth. But during this period, again there is rate of change of velocity. That means this rate of change of velocity is nothing but the acceleration. And this acceleration is produced only due to the earth gravitational force. Due to this reason, that acceleration is known as the acceleration due to gravity. According to the Newton's universal law of gravitation, suppose this is the earth surface and any object is placed at some height from the earth surface. The distance between these two object is small r. This is the mass of that object and this is the mass of the earth. This is the center of the earth and this is the radius of the earth. According to the Newton's universal law of gravitation, the force of attraction between the any two object is directly proportional to the product of their masses and inversely proportional to the square of distance between them. You have studied it, where G is the universal gravitational constant. At the place of M1, you can take the mass of the earth. At the place of M2, you can take the mass of that object. And R is the distance between their centers. That is nothing but the Newton's universal law of gravitation. Gravitational force produced between the two object give the imaginary equation number 1. But according to the Newton's second law of motion, F is equal to ma. M is the mass of the object and a is the acceleration. From equation 1 and 2, its left sides are equal. Therefore, right sides are also equal. Therefore, ma is equal to gmm divided by r square, where mass of the object get cancelled from both sides. It will get a is equal to gm divided by r square, where r is the distance between the center of these two objects. But when this object is placed on the surface of the earth, only at this time small, at the place of the small r, you can take the r. It will get a is equal to gm divided by r square, at the place of the a you can take the small g. This is nothing but the acceleration due to gravity. G is known as the universal gravitational constant. Capital M is the mass of the earth. Capital R is the radius of the earth. Therefore, the acceleration due to gravity depends upon the mass of the earth and radius of the earth. To a distance between these two objects does not depend upon the mass of the object. And when we put up the value of the universal gravitational constant, mass of the earth, radius of the earth, mass of the earth is equal to 6 multiplied by 10 raised to 24 kilogram, and radius of the earth is nothing but 6.4 into 10 raised to 6 meter, and put up the value of g, then the value of the acceleration due to gravity is equal to 9.77 or 9.78 meter per second square. Acceleration due to gravity is a vector quantity. But the value of the g on the surface of the earth is different for different place. We'll discuss about in next chapter.